We love talking to our next guest, Mel Kiper Jr., who knows football like no one else, and he's going to help us with Mr. Kyler Murray. Mel, it's Michael, Don, and Peter. How you doing?
Good, guys. How you been?
We're doing okay. So what is Kyler Murray? Where can we expect him to be selected? How good can he be?
Well, he's going to go very high. I think we all know that. I think what it is now is, okay, number one or number four. That's Arizona and Oakland. Does Arizona draft him with Kingsbury, you know, needing a quarterback with his, you know, doesn't Max protect? Then he needs a mobile quarterback in that offense. Does he take Kyler Murray at one and trade Josh Rosen to, say, Denver, who's picking 10 and get that 10th pick, or, say, Miami, you know, who's picking 13? And then does John Gruden maybe deal Derek Carr and draft Kyler Murray, knowing he has to outscore Patrick Mahomes for the next 9 years, and that's the end of his contract, and in 9 years, Patrick Mahomes will only be 32 years of age. If you get past those two, then you're getting into the Giants at 6, Jacksonville at 7, Denver at 10. I don't think that's going to happen. I think he goes in the top four overall, and I think the combine's going to be important to see, is he 5'9", 5'10", where does he stand there, the size of his hand, the how people view his body type when they see him face-to-face. He'll interview great. His football IQ's off the charts. His arm strength, his speed, his athleticism, his quickness, all phenomenal. So he doesn't have to throw. He doesn't have to run. His accuracy is outstanding throwing a football. I think the height and the hand size is going to be a determining factor of whether he does go that high and whether other teams embrace him and going to wrap their arms around Kyler Murray as a today-type NFL quarterback rather than the 1980s, 90s when he wouldn't have been viewed as anything but probably a position change and a third-round pick.
Yeah, we were just talking earlier, Mel, about how the fact that Baker Mayfield all of a sudden went to number one very early, probably got a week before the draft, right? So it really didn't happen until late. Can something similar happen here where these quarterbacks and the shuffle make everything that we're saying right now almost obsolete, where everything kind of changes a week before the draft?
Yeah, they all get moved up. They really keep moving and moving, and you keep adjusting, and the combine. And keep in mind, a lot of people didn't know, have any idea that Kyler Murray was going to be in this draft process. So during the year, he kept playing great. And then get into October, hey, he could maybe. And then get in November, they get into the playoffs. So I think people had to catch up. They didn't expect him to be anything other than right now at Oakland A, getting ready to report this Friday for spring training with the Oakland Athletics. So I think this caught a lot of people by surprise. They're hurrying up now, trying to catch up to Kyler Murray, the combine, pro day, obviously going back and watching tape. This kid was 42-0 in high school, 3 state championships in Allen, Texas. Obviously, the great year at Oklahoma, sat behind Baker Mayfield and learned that Lincoln Riley offense inside out. This is a Lincoln Riley offense, and a lot of NFL teams are trying to figure out how to take pieces of that and work with it in the NFL. So, I think he's got everything it takes. I said about 2 months ago, if he were 3 inches taller, he'd be the number one pick guaranteed, and he still may very well be the number one pick overall to Arizona if, in fact, they decide to trade Josh Rosen.
I'll tell you what, you startled me because everything I had been reading was, you know, maybe middle of the first round. So if he's going to go first to fourth, then he obviously made a good move not going to the Oakland A's. And my question to you, and I know you're not doing baseball here, but did the A's make a mistake? Did they misread this, or did he just come out of nowhere?
Couple things on that. I think they should not have, and I think it was a mistake to not force him to decide and not give him the opportunity to play at Oklahoma. Hey, if you're going to be in Oakland and I'm going to draft you ninth, you better be all in right away and going back to Oklahoma. Once you do that, it's a win-win for Baker, for Kyler. The only thing Kyler knew is after Baker Mayfield went number one, and Kyler's a very confident kid. He saw what happened with Baker. As you said, that late rise up to number one. Same offense, similar skill set, only faster and more athletic. And you think about accuracy, he completed almost the same percentage of pass. Right around 70% was his completion percentage, just about the same as Baker. He accounted for more touchdowns this year than Baker did last year. So he knew all that as the year went along. And I think what he was thinking here was, okay, if I do play great, I can get to the first round and become a football player. I don't think the Oakland A's, maybe because they thought was 5'9", 5'9 and a half. He didn't suit what the NFL is looking for. Maybe they underestimated that and how the NFL has changed. They certainly maybe didn't expect as a first-year starter. Remember, he had played at A&M, but wasn't the guy. Kyle Allen was there. So I think they just underestimated that. I just don't understand, guys, why you make a ninth pick, Kyler Murray, and you let him go have an option. And I think for Kyler, it was a win-win. The only negative for Kyler would have been a serious injury, which he unfortunately didn't sustain. So here we are. But if you're the Oakland A's, I think you underestimated how good a player and football quarterback back he could be. And he should have, I think, never been given that opportunity, like I say, to play that 1 year at Oklahoma.
Talking with Mel Kiper Jr. Well, Mel, we all agree that he's probably shorter than your prototypical quarterback, but does that matter anymore? Because the fact that you're saying that even though he's short, he could be taken first, it sounds like it doesn't matter anymore.
It really doesn't. Like, that's the thing. That you have to adjust your thinking. I'd speak to people in the league, and I think the old guard, you know, and I'm part of that now, is thinking, you know, really? Drew Brees was a second-round pick. Russell Wilson just 7 years ago was the 75th pick in the draft, third round. Had great years, great career at both NC State and Wisconsin. He was a third-round pick, like, say, 75 overall. Why? Because he was 5'10 and three quarters. Here we have a 5'9 and a half, say, quarterback, one-year sensation that could go number one or number four because of the way the game has changed, the fact that you see quarterbacks coming in. And I said 7 years ago he was going to be a test case. And I said it to John Gruden because John and I were there for that draft. And ironically, John's picking fourth and could be interested in Murray. But we said that's the test case. If Russell Wilson develops into a really good to great NFL quarterback, the height factor won't be an issue. If he struggles, it will be. And look what happened. So I think Russell Wilson really helped Murray. Now, Russell Wilson has a different body type than Murray's. Thicker. He was 210, 215 coming out. We'll see what Kyler Murray is. 185, 190, 195. We'll see. Obviously, you're giving up about an inch and a half there, possibly. Maybe even a half inch if he is 5'10, which some think 5'9 and a half. We'll see. But I think when you look at Kyler Murray, it's because of the way the NFL has changed. Mm-hmm. And the success of Russell Wilson, Baker Mayfield, has certainly led to what we see right now with this kid being projected as a top five pick, possibly.